my king for your glory. I will do anything just to see you, to behold you as my king. I wanna be.
Oh, need to worship him. The return of the lost to Jesus.
Elder Wilberforce,
Praise God. Today is the first Sunday in the new year 2018.
Amen.
So I just want to greet them personally. Greet Evangelist Fry today. Evangelist Fisher. Praise the Lord Jesus. I greet Evangelist Terry Fisher in the mighty name of Jesus. Minister Wilberforce in Jesus' name. Minister Wizard Gavin in the name of Jesus. What is that around the corner there? Praise the Lord Jesus. I want to greet Evangelist Reed in the name of Jesus today. Praise the Lord, our musician, our praise team. Greeting Minister Malav in the name of Jesus. It's a good while I have not been here. So let me say to you, just said the Lord God today. Because He is a good God and He wants to abide with us at home, warrior. But we must be honest and we must be humble and we must be obedient to that what He has given in His holy word unto us. God bless us. Father, we thank you. You are God all by yourself. As I stand here in need of you, Lord, more than ever, I ask you to speak to me today. Just bless your people. Help me, Lord, and let your blood cover me today. Take full control. Let your people listen to your word. Have your way in Jesus' name. Praise the Lord, church.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord, our Satan.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Praise God. Praise Him. Praise Him. Sister Patricia, could you turn to Ezekiel 37 for me and just read a few verses down there? Ezekiel 37, that's where we are going to be using and speaking from today. Go ahead.
Ezekiel 37. The hand of the Lord was upon me, and carried me out in the spirit of the Lord, and set me down in the midst of the valley of which was full of bones, and caused me to pass by them round about. And behold, there were very many in the open valley, and lo, they were very dry. And he said unto me, Son of man, can these bones live? And I answered, O Lord God, thou knowest. Again he said unto me, prophesy upon these bones, and say unto them, O ye dry bones, hear the word of the Lord. Thus saith the Lord God unto these bones, behold, I will cause breath to enter into you, and ye shall live. And I will lay sinews upon you, and will bring up flesh upon you, and cover you with skin, and put breath in you, and ye shall live, and ye shall know that I am the Lord. So I prophesied as I was commanded, and as I prophesied, there was a noise, and behold, a shaking, and the bones came together, bone to his bone. And when I beheld, lo, the sinews and the flesh came up upon them, and the skin covered them above, and there was no breath in them. Then said he unto me, prophesy unto the wind, prophesy, son of man, and say to the wind, thus saith the Lord God, come from the four winds, O breath, and breathe upon these slain, that they may live.
Amen. Bless you, Sister Pat. That is the word of the Lord. The hand of the Lord was upon me and carried me out in the spirit of the Lord and set me down in the midst of the valley where was full of bones. Hallelujah.
God spoke unto his prophet Ezekiel.
Yes.
And he went down in the valley through the spirit,
yes,
where the valley was filled with bones.
Amen.
But these bones were actually out of life.
Yes.
These bones were actually dead.
Yes.
And God spoke unto Ezekiel. God questioned Ezekiel and said, can these bones live? No, God had been God. And God commanded this man to go with the word. Then Ezekiel, like he was thinking, God is asking me, if these bones can live, God, you know it. You send it me, so you know whether they can live or not. It's like some of us as leaders and servants who God would send on a duty, and then we want to question him. Say, why, Lord? Is it now, Lord? But Ezekiel knew the God who he had been dealing with. And he answered him, thou knowest.
Amen.
You know it, Yehoshua. Nobody knows as God knows. So Ezekiel had the answer, even through the Spirit, to say unto the Lord.
Yes.
God say unto him, prophesy against them or upon them. Because he was about to do a great work upon these bones. Ezekiel did as the Lord told him to do. Prophesy against the bones. Something began to happen when the prophecy went forth. Bones began to come to bone. Sinews began to come upon the bones. The hack bones begin to make noise. Hallelujah. The knee bone began to make noise. The finger bone began to make noise. The back bone began to make noise. The hack bones began to make noise. So here was a noise in the valley after Ezekiel prophesy upon these bones. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
It's like the church today. When you hear the preacher preach, it may go through one ear and come through the other. But those bones were dry, and those bones were in trouble, and those bones were looking someone to rescue them. So they gave rough attention to the prophecy of Ezekiel unto them. And as soon as they began to take the prophecy very serious, things began to work. For here was a noise in the valley, meaning that something has gone forth, and somebody is listening to the voice of the Almighty God. So bone began to shake, bone began to cry out, bone stop listening, bone stop praising, bone stop moving. So foot start to move to the hand bone, and the hand bone start to move to the hand bone, and the hand bone start to move to the back bone, for the prophecy of Ezekiel begin to work. Shall we praise the Lord? Shall we praise the Lord? Shall we praise God? Glory to God. And after all these bones begin to work, life begin to come into them. This other joy, speakable, full of glory for this great miracle. Life begin to come into the bone. But there was still something was left there.
life in them. No breath was in them. God told him to speak unto the wind. And when he spoke unto the wind, breath started to minister unto the dry bone. And then the dry bone begin to know that this is the voice of God. And they begin to glorify God. So when we come to the house of God and we listen to his work and his word, we must begin to glorify God for many miracles he has wrought among us. Some of them we don't even know. The great miracle that he has wrought with us is the breath of life. Shall we worship the Lord? Shall we worship the Lord? For so many times, the enemy would like to take all the breath. But we have to challenge him. I challenged him the morning. And I said, if you are God, take all the breath. Tell me from those from Mount Royal this morning, you are not my God. And I challenge you. You can't kill me. If you don't say kill, you can't kill. If you don't say run, you can't run. If you don't say overshadow her and say she will curse me, you can't do it. Oh, devil. Let us walk in the light. Let us do the things that God would have us to do. So in time, he tries to mess up your mind. Bring your negative word. As I look at my young people, I see a time negative word. I can't bother. I am tired. Is there anything in this salvation? When I was over here, me always better. Me used to smoke me stiff. Me used to draw me cigarette. Me used to curse. Me used to girly. But now since me coming at this, me can't move. Me tied on. But let me tell you something. You tied on in the right thing. But this thing I send you power. You want to know who Jesus is. Don't let the man go back to where you coming from. For greater is he that is in you than that is in the world. Arise. Let the devil know that you are part of the prize. I'm talking to you, young brother. Sometimes you can't sleep at night. But he come focus you. He may even show you one devil girl. And say, you know, this girl can help you. Come out of that way, Elena. And come back in her name. Hallelujah. This woman cried. And Lord, help. And deliver him. Nothing that is not given to you. Yes, that is in Corinthians 7. Let no one touch none that is not given to you. Without in marriage, turn over. Don't let him hold it down. Don't let him draw you. Don't let him focus you. Give him the word of God. Hallelujah. Cry out and shout. The inhabitants of Zion, for great is the Holy One among alivio, now pastillo, I am the God of your salvation. It was a rough year. I don't know about you, but we are still here.
Amen.
The mighty God that we serve still keep us here.
Amen.
Keep lifting us up. Keep taking us when we rainfall. Thank God I am not a dry weather Christian. Shanda. I come out in the rain. Oh, because I have a love for God. And I believe in the love of God who takes you out in the rain. In 2017, some of us did not do much. Some people did not do well in the sight of God. More time was spent doing your whole thing, talking your whole talk, walk your whole walk, lie down your whole lie down. Hallelujah, God. Keep the company them when I tell you nothing good. Hallelujah. Look somewhere else where you're not to look. Somebody has looked somewhere else, you know.
Hey.
Don't look anywhere else. Look at what you have. Look at what God gives you. Hey, hey, hey. Be steadfast, unmovable. Always around me in the love of God. Don't let jealousy tear you up and get you in trouble. What you love? You like an old dress? You like a nice hat? You like having a pair of shoes? But to put you on can't buy it. But you now worth to buy it, you know what I mean? So can you open her in a pair of one dress? When God begins to move, and when God begins to bless, and He lifts up a standard, and He takes away your life, and says, come now, my son, my beloved, take this, for this is the land unto you. Go ahead, go ahead, and be blessed, take the blessing, it is yours. God wants to bless Mount Royal, but He's depending on us for certain things. And if we don't give it, we are not going to get the blessing. But He has it. It is in His hands. And He's just waiting to turn it over. But let me tell you, don't go back in anybody. Don't go back there. You're born. Maybe not the bone to get attention, because Ezekiel has still come down, but he'll pass you. Why not your time? Your time is up. Don't go back in there. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Your bones represent a lot of things. The bones can be represent stealing. The bones represent lying. The bones can represent fornication. The bones can represent adultery. The bones can represent bad mind. The bones can represent envy. The bones can represent cursing. The bones can represent digging out your mother here on the nearby field. The bones can make you cook a banana. That is not belonging unto you. The bones, hallelujah, can make you steal the taxi or the bus fare. You get by the chain, and you say, God provided. God don't provide the robbery, for He's the clean God.
Hallelujah.
Sometime last week, I gave somebody some money, and I said to him, it is XY. And I said, okay, the person didn't check it. And it was yesterday or the day before. The person came back to me and said, Pastor, it wasn't that, you know. It was more than that you gave me. It was X you gave me. I said, yes, it was more than what I thought. God bless you. Thank you for your honesty.
Yes.
Most people read, they will laugh and say, God provide this. And we ask it. God make me pastor. Give me the hope of one. You are a king. In the name of Jesus. Don't take it. Don't take anything that's in the church that is left over. Somebody forget it. I hear say you need one thing. Is that out of the Bible? You keep it and say you need one. And see you get one along. You are so wrong. You are a thief. Go to the church of the living God. Come out of the things that will not exalt you before the Lord Jesus Christ. We are his children, and he watches us more than ever. 2018 needs a great change and a great turn for the people of God. In North Boston, in 2017, everybody saying, may I make example? School was the topic, education was the topic, Lord God Almighty, and the workplace was the topic. Jesus came behind for little or none. Hey, hallelujah. Was given to the Lord. Don't let it be like that in this year. Get up and do what you have to do, God. You know, Lord, pastor, I will call you and tell you something. So call her and ask her, is the sister I cooking today? What about the children? They have a plan for the new year. We have a plan. You didn't do well at all. The Holy Ghost is not pleased with some of his people. Let me tell you, saints of God, God never pleased 2017. He's not done blessed yet. He has more visa to give you.
Yes.
He has more wedding to perform.
Yes.
More baby to born.
Yes.
And bless. More food to come from somewhere to you.
Yes.
More clothes.
Yes.
More barrel to come.
Yes.
I say if you will want to do, he will turn the blessing upon you. You're coming so long and you don't know where the husband has come from. In there somewhere, in the other field, in waiting on you, but your lifestyle can't make you get him. You have to give up sometimes, you God. You have to give sacrifice. If you want something good, you better give up the sacrifice. Yeah. And so look how long they have got it, and God will give me nobody. God, I'm giving good things to God. Work! Are you straight? Are you proud? Look at his brain. Straight! Are you straight? Cry out in there. And shout. A great, and you're the one among you. The blessing upon us. Glory to God, church. What a mighty God we serve. What a God who is desirous to give us the things that we need. Not what we want, but what I never thought want. So you get things that you need from the Lord. But when you start to plead in a want, you do some things to get want. You go to some sidewalk and stand up. You make a date with the wrong person to get the ones. Hallelujah. Then you come to Pastor Reed
and say, God provide this. Mm-hmm. If God not provide nothing, she will tell you before I'm going to pray, but she not think of so. And God provide us that. For God is a good God, and God give good things. But I tell you something, let this year be a better year for the Lord Church of God. You didn't know last year, they have a name, no. Yes, the missionary department never do one thing. Hallelujah. Never do nothing. We don't get together, make it be a better year. Hallelujah. Minister of God, we don't never do a leader. Emoshata. Shanda. Ekemosa. Where is the blind man? Where is the man born? We need to come together. When you find him, you find the sick man, you find the half-dead sister, hello Messiah. You find the one naked, you know who naked? You never did well. Emotion. Hello Messiah. The one deacon indeed well. Instead could have been more. Yes, deacon, you could have been like more. You do well. The musician, they don't do nothing to. Need more fasting and prayer. Make God bless the department and show you open work. Hallelujah. The choir, God, hear what you should be here today. Ministering to God, nobody can be found. Where is the choir? Where is the choir? You need to get your back and come to the choir master and say, I am ready. Here I am, choir master. Be ready to start up a business. Go around, look for one another and start up 2018. Let it be a successful year. Don't do what you like. You come on when you're ready. And you go off when you're ready. You have stop light. You're not touching green. You are red and yellow. You need to move. You need to move. Don't go back. Don't go back to the pool of Bethesda. 38 years, you were there sitting down. Your entry has passed. Every time you try, my detect down before you. And you stay there with your cripple foot. Until when Jesus passed by and give you the green light. He said, get up and walk and jump. Hallelujah. Then after that miracle, you want to go back. You want to go down back in the valley. Where you want to go in the valley? You may say something had done to your one hooked if you go back in the valley. Stand far to the liberty. This is my cause. We give that strive in me. Get wool and shield and buckle. Hand up! Lord God, I need you 2018. Why rock me? If I rock the generation, if I rock the children, if I rock the school, if I rock the teacher, if I rock the minister, if I rock the prime minister, if I rock the opposition. Cry out and shout.
Oh, Jesus!
Hallelujah! Of Zion, let us walk worthy in this vocation wherewith we are called. I need to sing the choir, not only for anniversary, it is the joy in your ministry today. Oh, you know, Christian God, when anything happened, when another happened, when the thing said that anniversary was one piece of anniversary, that was one piece of worldwide anniversary. And you need to ask God what happened, why the choir back down after anniversary year, choir back down.
leader on that anniversary went all over the globe. Might be no free village again, but get up and walk. Move from the pool, don't make your foot get crippled by your memory. And Jesus pass you again, and you have to wait another 30 years here.
Oh, Jesus!
Don't fool it, God. When he puts in a position, acknowledge it and praise him for it. Accept what God gave to do in Dream House. And at this year, I want to see all the minister bring in a one good man. Lord have mercy. Bring in a naked sister. If it's that the way God wants it. I get a millionaire brother. Before they bring that whole church and fix it the whole God wants it. We are in need. We are in need in this church. You have to make yourself humble. You have to make yourself the person that God wants you to be. This year, use your Bible. Talk to it. Make prayer with it. Find the words. Make it cheer you up. Make it cheer you up. But God, you walk with your proud and scornful. Humble yourself to walk with him. The word is perfect. It is spoken by the Almighty God. Don't let anyone fool you. Negative thoughts with bad company will spoil your salvation. You know, when you're walking on the road and you're well dressed, and you see some young men behind you, and you begin to start to whistle you and say, "Hi, fatness, fatness." You know, you got nothing with God. The most thing they have to say when they pass you, Christian. You then dance a Christian to you. You're wrong. Your skirt too short, and they must see the big part of your leg. Hello, Shanda. Is that them a talk about? Them a call after you because them see that. Why you give them something to say?
Hey, Lord.
Holy Ghost. Help me, Lord. Walk out of that to 2018.
Yes.
Put yourself like Christian. Because if a born again, apostolic young man see you so, then they call it to you, but you are not the favor. Emotion. Well, if you see Alan Robbie, we tell you to stop. I love to talk with you. They call you on the phone and said lightly, "How you dress?" And you have to do better. If we have to move on, something has to be done.
Oh, Jesus.
Don't let this year, 2017, was a bad, troublesome, bad year for me and some situation in the church that I didn't like. I can't manage. God don't like it. But I said, let them stay. You speak, you chastise, you take over.
Jesus.
When you are ready, let us get up and ride. Let us run. Let us take up a board. Out of the body. The amount of members that are here, if each of you bring in a bad board and get protected right, till they start shake, until you start to come on, and bread start to come. The angels in heaven will rejoice for your working. Stop thinking about work. Stop thinking about school. Stop putting those things before God. I am not saying that your education is not relevant. Yes, it's nice to be educated. I see great pain inside of this church. Only when I put it in front of God and take some little dry lie, when you can really come to church. Because you don't want to come. But Satan take time and a stumble. Get rid of some negative thoughts.
Oh, Jesus.
God love you. And yes, let me tell you again, we have something coming out about the tithes and offering. Mm-hmm. That you must do better for 2018. You are not doing what God wants to be done in that area of the church you like. And you see, when you start through that, you can challenge God with anything you want. You know, understand. And when you're a giver, you challenge God for anything. When you give a one thing, God give you two money. That's the God we serve. And you must be a lover. You must love God, people. You must love your pastor. Amen, of God. Everybody bows your head, no pastor. Pastor get poor card for Christmas. Look at the congregation. You left me sad, but I love you. You know who love? Pastor Reed. Love her congregation. And I just want to see you do what God wants you to do and live for Him. You're my friend. Can hope you kiss you and you draw whenever time. But when you're not walking right, you hide from me. You won't come around the office and say, Pastor, how you doing? You won't call me on the phone and say, Pastor, how you doing? I don't bother with you. You call you to say much because you're hiding. Why are you hiding? You can't hide from the shepherd who God has given you. Stand fast. Cry out and shout. Something is happening. Don't let go. Don't let the devil have it over you. Don't let him smear you. And some of us jump and dance at an anointing. Sometimes it's not an anointing. God is spanking you. And if you are not in the spirit, or God has given you the discernment, you say, Lord, Sister Mary was happy in the spirit today. You're getting a clap. But sometimes you don't want to drop everybody to the floor. We are looking for greeting to happen in this church. 2018. Arise. Don't go back in the valley. Among those bones, you have already been prophesied to, and the wind has blown upon you. Keep it, respect it, collect it, get your blessing from the Almighty God. Don't run, don't let a bad friend tell you that salvation is not good. Is there anything as good as salvation? That God who died and Calvary and shed his blood has given unto our people. Let us rejoice, be exceedingly glad, for great will be your reward in heaven. God bless you. Amen.
Sought the Lord, and He answered me and delivered me from every fear. Those who look on Him are radiant, they'll never be ashamed, they'll never be ashamed. This poor man cried, and the Lord heard.